there are two films whose connection has been discussed in film circles, yet which deserves a continued look in regards to that connection. The Conversation and Enemy of the State are films which both involve nefarious plots by people in positions of power. Technology's position and effect upon the world of surveillance is at the root of each film, though Enemy's story is wider in scope. Both films delve into the important discourse of these constantly developing and shifting technologies and the role of government and personal civil liberties in the technologies being more invasive, more effective, and increasingly utilized.
Here it is.
John, give us lat 30, 64 minutes, long 72, 29 minutes.
There they are. Coming in from top left. Let's go in there and get them.
40s.
They've infected everything.
We'll get into your bank statements, computer files, email, listen to your phone calls.
My wife's been saying that for years.
Every wire, every airway.
More technology you use, the easier it is for them to keep tabs on you. It's a brave new world out there.
Pratt. Or is that like a...
In a making-of interview, director Tony Scott said how he wanted to capture the tone of the great 70s paranoid thrillers. And this he does, as Enemy feels like a natural progression, an extension of those unique films of the 70s. Works centered by films like The Conversation, Enemy is almost like a sequel to The Conversation. Scott mentions 3 Days of the Condor as inspiration. Released 24 years after The Conversation, there are few instances where two films have been so serendipitously linked. The film The Limey and Poor Cow comes to mind, which are linked through the actor Terrence Stamp. Both films center on information and data collection and privacy themes. Check out the link to a tremendous blog post that I provide, which shows some of the connective links and mise-en-scene story and character between the two films. Within the story, there are many connections, such as the workplace space for Brill and Caul, called The Jar and The Enemy of the State.
I call it The Jar. No phone or utility lines coming in, self-contained, unplugged from the world, nothing for a wire bug to piggyback in on. That leaves only transmitters. It's easy enough to signal sweep for those.
Signal sweeping for transmitters. You're just a party animal.
What the hell is happening?
I blew up the building.
Why?
Because you made a phone call.
Therein lies the most important connective link. By casting Gene Hackman, Enemy is able to invest a dimensionality to the Brill character and a depth to the story, as Brill seems like a continuation of Hackman's character Harry Caul from The Conversation. It is as if Harry Caul has become the reclusive Edward Brill Lyle. In the making of interviews on casting, Scott and producer Jerry Bruckheimer mentioned wanting Hackman in the role to create this natural connection for viewers. Scott also mentions how he was keen to cast Hackman after the success on Crimson Tide. Notice in the Enemy trailer end credits, you see some of the writers listed who worked on a screenplay other than the screenwriter who often receives the sole credit on the film, David Marconi.
those other writers who ultimately didn't receive screenplay credit are some of the best and top-notch in the industry. People like Aaron Sorkin, Henry Bean, and Tony Gilroy. Enemy of the State screenwriter David Marconi was kind enough to respond to my email regarding the Hackman connection. He mentioned how the conversation, he had seen it prior, so the Hackman character was clearly in his subconscious. Marconi also mentioned how the Hackman Caul character was a role type in developmental meetings. Marconi also mentions how when it came time to cast the film, Scott and Bruckheimer had a relationship with Hackman through their collaboration on Crimson Tide, so they sent him the script and Hackman responded favorably.
This is a world of hidden mics and two-way mirrors. A world where nothing is private.
You think we can do this?
Later in the week.
You think we can do this?
Harry Caul is an expert. The best there is.
Let me tell you something about Harry Caul. The best, bar none. I'll drink to that.
The best what?
The best bugger on the West Coast.
What about me?
He can bug anybody, anytime, anywhere.
Nobody knows how you did it, though, Harry. It caused a hell of a scandal, too.
Did you see him? The man with the hearing aid, like Charles. He's been following us all.
They're not people to him. Just voices.
Three people were murdered, that's all.
He doesn't know them, and they don't know him.
It had nothing to do with me. I mean, I just turned in the tapes.
Bless me, Father, for I've sinned. I've been involved in some work that I think will be used to hurt these two young people. No way responsible. I'm not responsible.
You're not supposed to feel anything about it. You're just supposed to do it.
Be careful, Harry. You're just supposed to listen. Not look. Not feel. Not care.
Yes. How'd you get this phone number?
We prepare a full dossier on everyone.
It's terrific. The bugger got bugged,
huh? Do I have secrets, Harry? I know you do. Telling me about yourself? Your secrets?
I don't have any secrets.
Don't get involved in this, Mr. Caul. These tapes are dangerous.
Come on, Harry. Show and tell. How do you do it?
Why are you asking me these questions?
Gene Hackman is Harry Caul in The Conversation. There is nothing private about The Conversation.
My name is Harry Caul. Can you hear me?
Yeah, so Julie, I'm gonna finish up my Christmas shopping. Hey, do chicks dig lingerie?
Hi.
Hey, hi.
What size?
Yeah, right. She's a six.
What about cup size?
I'm sorry? Oh, she's way bigger than that. I mean, not noticeably.
Help me.
Robert Clayton Dean. He's a DC labor attorney.
Take us around to the other side.
Focus on the drop.
Is it a tape?
A powerful man has been murdered.
Holy.
A hidden camera recorded the crime.
None of this goes beyond us. We don't need any more problems, do we?
An innocent bystander.
Are those my Christmas presents?
In your dreams, buddy.
Was given the evidence.
We have reason to believe that Mr. Zavitz may have passed sensitive materials to you.
No, he didn't pass me anything.
How did you happen to be at Ruby's today?
I was shopping for some lingerie. That's still legal, isn't it?
For your wife?
No, I was picking something up for myself. I do a little cross-dressing on the weekends.
Let's get into his life.
Produced by Jerry Bruckheimer.
Take his wife and kid. He give it up for them.
Target switching.
Directed by Tony Scott.
Why are they after me?
Two targets, rooftop.
You have something they want!
I don't have anything!
immediate keyhole visual tasking. Target is on 21.
Don't do this to me.
Get out! 19.
I've been a law-abiding citizen my whole life. One day with you, shoot.
He's running! He's on your 6 o'clock!
Will Smith.
Certainly carjacked a really nice car.
Gene Hackman. You're either incredibly smart or incredibly stupid.
We'll see in a minute.
Enemy of the state.
Should have gotten our watch.
Former conspirer.
Yeah, I used to work for the NSA.
I was a communication analyst.